Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Dear students, I hope all of you are well. By the grace of Almighty Allah, I am also well. Welcome to our online platform of NIVS Home School. Dear students, now I am going to conduct agriculture studies class for the students of class 8. And dear students, our today's topic is chapter 1, lesson 2 and 3. And for this lesson, I have just summarized the lesson, the two lessons, and you have to follow it. So let's come to the board. Dear students, chapter 1, lesson 2 and 3. Lesson 2 was about lifestyle and culture of Bangladeshi people and modernization of agriculture. Dear students, you know that agriculture was the main way of income of our Bangladeshi people from the ancient period. Okay, so from the ancient period we are close to the activities of the agriculture. As a result, the people of ancient period they used to produce crops, but how much they produced the crops, it was very much limited. Okay, so to produce a lot of crops, modern instruments are very much needed. Okay, and you know that during the time of Second World War, Japanese soldiers either vanished our crops or grains of crops. Not only ours, they also vanished or collected the crops from our grains, our country's grains, or from India. And as a result, on that time a great famine was held. Okay, as a result, agriculture universities, or British tried to set up agriculture universities in our country. As a result, Shere Bangla agriculture universities and in an agriculture universities in Kumilla was set up on that time. And along with, after that period, in Pakistani period, different research centers, one jute, tea and sugarcane, and other crops also set up in Dhaka or in Ishwardi or in Srimangal. And besides, in Ghazipur a lot of research center was set up in Pakistani period. Okay, and modernization of agriculture of Bangladesh started in basically from 1960s. Distance 1960s means 1960 to 1969. Okay, so in this period the modernization of Bangladeshi agriculture was basically held to a great extent. As a result, rice, egg, milk, meat, leather products, etc. were produced to a great extent, because from this time farmers were able to cultivate their crops scientific way, by using scientific method. Okay, by using very much easiest way. Okay, and this was done for this scientist's contribution. Okay, that means on that time scientists were very much able to produce the crops which are from the crops seeds which are very much updated, developed or hybrid. As a result, this was able by the farmers to produce that great amount of crops. And this is about lesson 2. Dear students, now we will discuss about lesson 3, chapter 1, lesson 3, advancement of agriculture in different countries in the world. That means how the advancement or how the method of cultivation is in different countries of the world. It may be our neighboring countries India and our another neighboring countries China, Vietnam. Okay, so let's start advancement of agriculture in independent Bangladesh. You know that after getting independent from in 1971, Bangladeshi agriculture was very much developed also. okay? That means then how it developed? In our country too, veterinary training institute was set up. That means what is veterinary training institute? Veterinary training institute means those institutes where animals, method of treatment, animals, everything is researched. Okay, that means how updated animals can be produced, okay, and how they are rearing, how they are caring, how they are grown up in a easiest way, and how to get many profit by cultivating these animals to a short time. This research are done veterinary training institutes, okay, and along with these institutes also give training to those people who are along with such kind of works, okay. And besides this, after the liberation era of our country, in our universities agriculture department of agriculture was also set up, and as a result poultry farming and fishes, cultivation of fishes, were also shown to a great extent. That means poultry's production and fish production were too much on that time, and our government, from that time our government influences our farmers to plant more trees, okay, and to plant they tried to fulfill tree plantation programs. As a result, farmers were very much eager to produce or to plant more trees, and by doing this they were very much benefited. And besides this, after our liberation war, advancement of biotechnology or genetic engineering. Dear students, what is genetic engineering? Genetic engineering means the engineering through which any seeds updated version is to be created, and by doing this farmers are able to produce hybrid crops, and you know that hybrid crops are very much beneficial to the farmers to produce a lot of crops, okay. Agriculture in India. Dear students, you know that India is a large country like China, and as a result in India there is a large acres of plain land. As a result, they are very much good at producing flowers, fruits, vegetables, meat, fish, etc. And then agriculture in China. You know that China is also very much bigger country than India. As a result, in China rice, wheat, maize, etc. are grown to a great extent. So our country's researcher also can get help from those countries for producing hybrid crops, okay. Then agriculture in Vietnam. Dear students, Vietnam's agriculture is also very much updated, and FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, this organization also always plays an important role to produce updated crops. And you know that in the year 2020, this organization, Food and Agriculture Organization, got Nobel Prize in Peace. Dear students, this was basically about chapter 1 and lesson 2 and 3. And from this chapter, you will have HW number 2. Homework number 2, make 5 MCQ. Okay, you have to make 5 MCQ from this discussion, and your submission date is 20 February 2021. Dear students, this is all about today's class. I hope you all have understood today's class, and for your better understanding you must watch this video, and after watching it go to the textbook and read it. Hopefully it would be very much easier to you. This is the end of the class. Assalamualaikum warahmatullah.